Hello, my name is Erin. This tutorial shows how to use the ruler in Microsoft Word. First, we're going to display the ruler. Then we're going to use the ruler to change the margins, indent the first line in each paragraph, create hanging indents, and add tabs. Today I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365 on a PC. These steps also apply to the single purchase versions of the software back to Word 2013. We'll cover this topic in Word for Mac in a separate tutorial. To display the ruler, select the View tab in the ribbon. From there, ensure that you're in Print Layout View. And then select Ruler in the Show group. A horizontal ruler should now appear under the ribbon, and a vertical ruler should now appear on the left side of your screen. If your vertical ruler is missing, you can display it by selecting the File tab in the ribbon, and then selecting Options in the Backstage view. When the Word Options dialog box appears, select the Advanced tab. And then select Show Vertical Ruler in Print Layout View in the Display section. Finally, select the OK button. Your vertical ruler should now appear. To use the ruler to change your page margins, hover your pointer over the center of the left or right end of the horizontal ruler until your pointer becomes a double arrow. You may also see a tooltip that says left margin or right margin. Slide the double arrow to the right or left to adjust the margin. To adjust the top or bottom margins, hover your pointer over the center of the top or bottom of the vertical ruler until your pointer again becomes a double arrow. Then slide the double arrow up or down. Before we move on, note that you can press and hold the Alt key on your keyboard as you move any of the markers on the ruler to see precise measurements. Now we're going to use the ruler to indent the first line of each paragraph. To begin, place your cursor in one of the paragraphs. Then select the Home tab in the ribbon, followed by Select in the Editing group. From there, choose Select Text with Similar Formatting in the drop-down menu. This option will select all the paragraphs in the document without items you most likely don't want to indent, such as headings and figures. Next, move the top ruler marker to the right to the desired indent length. A hanging indent extends the first line of a paragraph farther to the left than the rest of the lines. To create a hanging indent, place your cursor inside the individual paragraph, or select multiple paragraphs if you want to create several hanging indents simultaneously. However, avoid selecting the entire document with methods such as Ctrl+A because you'll select headings and other items that don't normally have hanging indents. Next, slide the bottom triangle marker on the ruler to the right. The square marker will move with the bottom triangle marker. In Word, the Tab key on your keyboard moves your cursor to a specific location called a tab stop. Tabs can be used to indent paragraphs, but they can also be used for other purposes, including creating single and multi-column lists. To add tabs to your ruler, press Ctrl+A to select the entire document, or select the portion of your document to which you want to apply the tab. If you don't select all or part of your document, before creating your new tab, it will only apply to the paragraph your cursor is currently in or newly created content. Next, click the Tab Selector button until it changes to the symbol representing the tab you want. The left tab stop, which is the most common, places the left aligned text to the right of the tab stop. The center tab centers text on the tab stop. The right tab places right aligned text to the left of the tab stop. The decimal tab aligns characters based on the first decimal placed on the tab stop. The bar tab creates a vertical line at the tab stop. Technically, this isn't a tab. Instead, it's for formatting multi-column lists. Click the location on the ruler where you want to place the tab stop. The tab symbol will then appear on the ruler. You can place multiple tab stops on the ruler. Each time you press the tab key, your cursor will move to the next stop. If you would like to delete a tab, pull the tab symbol downward and release it. It will be removed from the ruler. And as always, remember to save your file to save your changes. All the steps we just performed are listed with images on my website at erinwrightwriting.com, which is linked in the description box below, along with my playlist, How to Use Microsoft Word, which offers many related tutorials, including how to change the unit of measurement for the ruler, margins, and indents in Microsoft Word. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss upcoming tutorials. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.